in China.
The historic show was, of course, sold out. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Fresno, California. And what a night it has been already. And it only gets better because The Undertaker will return to SmackDown later here tonight. Right now, let's show you what happened last Friday. Drew McIntyre versus Christian. Cody Rhodes was joining us ringside.
Christian was taking a hellacious beating until the Crucifix roll-up, and Captain Charisma was victorious. But the night would not end there for Christian.
Here is your winner, Christian.
It was almost as if this attack was pre-planned. Drew McIntyre and Cody Rhodes working together to stomp away here on Christian.
Well, Christian is not alone. Matt Hardy and Christian, friends, brothers in the WWE universe, but then Matt's injured left ankle would become a target of dashingly sinister Drew McIntyre and Cody Rhodes.
I think it's clear both Cody and Drew McIntyre are not content just to win matches. They're out to hurt people.
Well, Cody Rhodes spoke of a changing of the guard. Some are already saying that this next superstar may very well be the King of the Castle.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you Alberto Del Rio's personal ring announcer, Ricardo Rodriguez.
Alberto Del Rio has a personal ring announcer and a bevy of collectible cars. Last week was a Rolls Royce. This week, it's a Jaguar. And from what I understand, he has over 50 classic cars valued at over $10 million.
There's Aston Martin, Sterling, and of course, this part of the vintage car collection, the Jaguar. And notice Alberto left the headlights on, so you can really see his greatness.
I think we saw his quote-unquote greatness earlier tonight and what he did to a weakened and beaten down Rey Mysterio.
Well, there is the benevolent one. Notice the white scarf is a sign of purity in early Spaniard Castilian royalty. Thus, Alberto Del Rio is making it current and present today.
Alberto Del Rio victorious last week in his first night here on Friday Night SmackDown. Well, Matt, Alberto Del Rio claims to be the greatest of the great, but how can you claim that when we saw what Alberto Del Rio did earlier tonight to Rey Mysterio? How is that great?
This is magnifico. This is Don Alberto, the Umbernesto, a man of virtue, a man of pride. Look into the eyes of Friday Night SmackDown's very own Alberto Del Rio. So much fun to say.
And making his way to the ring from Fresno, California, weighing in at 197 pounds, Carlos Sanchez.
I just mentioned it. Let's show you what happened earlier tonight between Alberto Del Rio and Rey Mysterio. Mysterio just finished competing in a no disqualification match with the Big Red Monster Kane. And look at Del Rio targeting Mysterio's left arm.
That is what Carlos Sanchez has to deal with. Of course, Carlos, a three-time state champion here in California, his family on hand to witness this. And now Alberto Del Rio will soil his hands with Carlos Sanchez.
Vicious. I don't think Alberto Del Rio has ever gotten his hands dirty. And a bloodline of kings, he owns a giant mansion in Mexico. Has several, what he calls, peasants helping him do all his dirty work, so to speak.
Let me ask you, and this is also for the viewers to debate at home, can you remember a more prolific debut in SmackDown history than that of Alberto Del Rio? Well, let the debate begin.
Del Rio said that he would make Rey Mysterio respect him.
Whoa, nice Castilian belly-to-back suplex. And notice Alberto clad in white, again, a sign of purity.
Now Del Rio, well, I thought he was going to go for a cover instead. trying to cut off the oxygen of Carlos Sanchez. Hey, voting is now open for NXT, ladies and gentlemen. Who will be WWE's next breakout star? We're down to the final three. Matt, have you gone on record with who you think's going to win?
Well, I have voted, of course, the season finale this Tuesday. We're going to find out together. Let's not forget, season one's winner, Wade Barrett, has gone on to amazing things on Monday Night Raw.
Who did you vote for? You're always dancing around the question. Answer one question, please.
Really? You want me to get political right now?
I just want to hear the answer to a question.
Right now, I vote for Alberto Del Rio as the new bright, shining star of Friday Night SmackDown. How about that?
Sanchez creating space. Whoa, look at this. Del Rio didn't expect this kind of offense.
See now the benevolence, sportsmanship, virtue, honor.
It's like the calm before the storm from Del Rio.
I kind of like the wink, you know, it's a sign of confidence. It's a touch condescending. It's also deemed disrespectful in many parts of the world.
Del Rio from San Luis, Mexico. His family, one of the richest in the entire country. He hails from bloodline of kings of royalty. And there it is, the armbar breaker.
The cross arm breaker, all the pressure on the shoulder, elbow, and bicep. Hecho in Mexico, Alberto Del Rio. How can you not be impressed with this?
I am impressed.
Say it while rolling your eyes. Take a look here.
Alberto Del Rio defeated Rey Mysterio last week, and had little problem with Carlos Sanchez tonight, but it was the same move that ended the contest versus Rey that won this match tonight. And there's the arrogant wink.
Beautiful. Watch the way Alberto goes into it. Such fluidity, and then beautiful hyperextension of the left arm. Congratulations, Alberto Del Rio.
No one has beaten him, ladies and gentlemen. Alberto Del Rio. Dos y zero. That's 2-0. Hey, here's Beauty and the Beast, the giant seven-footer, the Big Show, is in action next on Friday Night SmackDown.
Wow, 900 episodes of Raw, WWE in China. What an awesome time it is.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, standing 7 feet tall, weighing at 485 pounds, the Big Show.
Here's a trivia question for you, Matt. Who was in the main event on